Hi everyone, it's Vicky here and welcome back to another video. Today I'm showcasing the latest card kit by Spellbinders. Just like always, we are going to take a quick look on what's included in the kit and then I'm going to share 10 cards. Just like always, in the kit you will find a leaflet. This is going to give you 3 card ideas and some instructions at the back. Let's take a look at the basics. You always get 10 envelopes and 10 white pre-folded cards in a standard size. You'll also get tape adhesive as well as foam adhesive. This month you will get a bag with sequins. I like the color of it because it is iridescent and it matches pretty much any card that you make, any color combo. And let's take a look at the ties. These are really versatile. They are flowers that you can layer. There are different layers for each flower. You can use them separately or combine different colors. I will make one card using those and I absolutely love them. They make beautiful flowers. You get leaves as well and different sizes of flowers. And let's take a look at the stamp set. This month the stamp set is full of sentiments. It is perfect for party invitations. They even give you a table that you can use. It combines different fonts, smaller and larger, that the smaller ones fit inside that table. And this is a stamp set you will go back to whenever you make an invitation. Now let's take a look at the stickers. These are chipboard stickers. They are really thick and they really make a statement. They make great focal points. You get both designs as well as big sentiments. And you can take a look at the thickness here. Now, I have to apologize about the sounds that you may hear from outside my window. The dogs are barking and that's because the weather is wonderful here in Greece. I have to keep my windows open as I prefer to get fresh air instead of using my air condition. So now let's take a look at the alphabet. These are foam stickers, nice and thick, and they combine gold foiling at the bottom and little black lines at the top. And now let's take a look at the paper pad. Just like every month, you get a pad of 6x6 pages. There are 20 different designs. You get 2 pages for each design. And some of them are foiled. So you will see something sparkling here and there. Like this page, for example. So in total, 40 pages, which are not double-sided. I like using pattern paper in my designs and you will see that in the 10 cards that I will be making today, I will use lots of the different designs in this pad. You will also get 9 cardstock pages in different colors. One of them is a gold foiled one. And now for my favorite part of the month, when I open up the package with the die cuts. There are hundreds of them in the package. You will see that you get 2 die cuts for each design, which means that you can recreate easily lots of cards. I like to lay them all around my craft table so that I can see what I got. And I create categories because they make my life easy. So up there I have all the banners. You'll see that here I have everything that has to do with food. My llamas are together, all the sentiments on one side. This makes it easy for me to create clusters of elements that match together and would make a great focal point on a card. So let's start with the first card for today. I'm using this pattern paper, which I'm going to cut into being 4.25 by 5.5. This is going to completely cover up the card front. And then I have picked up a white cardstock, which is slightly smaller, just to create a layer there. I used a stitched rectangle die to cut it out, so I do have some interest all around the edges. And I'm going to combine the 2 die cuts with the houses. The one with the 2 houses is going to go flat on my card, while for the second one I'm going to use some foam tape to pop it on my card. This is going to make it look more interesting. Just by using dimension, you can make a really simple card into looking more special. And in my videos where I am creating 10 cards using products from a card kit, I make my best to use only products from the kit, except from glue, for example. And I also make really simple cards so that I can fit them inside a 20-minute video. This makes them all really easy to recreate, perfect for any beginner. You can play along and make even more cards, since at the end you will end up having lots and lots of products that you haven't used yet. So I added a gold heart and one of the chipboard stickers, and here are some photos on the first card for today. For the second card, I picked three of the circles from the die cuts, as well as all the cacti that were included, and I'm going to use the circles as a way to ground all those pots somehow. I'm making sure that I am using contrasting colors so that they pop on top of the background, and I'm also going to use this yellow sentiment to complete my card. Now that I like the placement, all I have to do is to put everything down. For the circles, I'm going with glue, so this is going to lay flat on top of my card base. And for the cactus, I'm going to use at the back some foam squares so that I can pop them on top and add some dimension. A quick and fun card that I think it looks very trendy, and it would make a great card for a teenager. And you can see here some close-up photos on the second card. For the third card, I picked lots and lots of those die-cuts, and I'm going to create a cluster. As the background, I will use this foiled background. I'm going to cut it to size, and this is going to be 4.25 by 5.5, and it is going to cover up completely the card front. Now I will use this white panel that I have cut out with a stitched rectangle die. I'm going to stick that on top of my background, and this is going to provide a place where I'm going to stick everything. I don't want to have too much of a design at the background, since I'm going to use lots and lots of those die cuts, and I want to keep things quite plain. And now this is why I don't like to use tape adhesive at the back. I usually prefer to work with my Nouveau Deluxe glue, just because I can always slide the panels one on top of the other until I'm happy with the placement. Here it is a little bit crooked, I think, but I'm going to embrace it since I cannot do anything else. Now I'm using at the back of my sentiment some foam tape so that I can pop it on my panel. And then I'm going to use all the rest of the die cuts and tuck them underneath. This could make a great card for a gathering or a great card for a party, which is something that we shouldn't do now that we have the virus. But we all hope that things are going to go back to normal, so let's have one of those cards handy for when we are finally going to invite our friends. So as you can see, I picked things that remind you of a party. So you can see here I have a guitar, I also have a bottle of wine, a cake for maybe this is a gathering for a birthday, and finally I have a glass. And you see I have some empty space there, which I'm going to fill in with a heart. And I'm going to complete the sentiment by sticking one more die cut at the bottom. And here are some close-up photos. Now, if you love barbecue parties, then this set is perfect for you. You will find lots of things that have to do with barbecue, and we definitely love this in our house. So I'm going to show you a couple of ideas on how you can make two cards using those. Both of them are quite masculine, and they would make a great Father's Day card, especially if he loves this activity. So I'm going to stick this panel on top of my standard card, and you can see it is slightly smaller, so I end up having a border. And I'm going to arrange the little die cuts on top. And I'm going to create a cluster here, so I picked bits and pieces. I'm trying to decide where everything is going to go, and I want to have that burst of light behind that sausage. I don't also like the shape of this sentiment, and that's exactly why I'm going with my scissors. I am leaving a black border all around. This is going to completely change the look of it. And then I'm going to stick everything down. Now you get two designs of this die cut, but you can get the exact same thing in a different size on the card chipboard stickers. So you can use any one you like. I'm going with a die cut, and I will show you another card later on using the exact same design, so you get a couple of ideas. Now, just like always, when I am creating a cluster card, some of the elements go completely flat on my card base and others go with a foam tape at the back just to add some dimension. I think that having that dimension really makes a simple card looking more interesting. For my sentiments at the top of my card, I'm going with this one that says Kiss the Cook and the other one that I cut around it that says Barbecue Master. And this is going to complete my card. And I know my husband is going to love this card, so I'm going to show you another way on how you can use these two elements. This time I'm using a busy pattern paper that has everything to do with barbecue again. If you notice the designs, you will see that it matches perfectly with the focal points that I chose to go with. Again, since I have a busy background, I'm going to use a little white panel at the top. This is going to allow for the focal points to pop on top of the card. And again, I'm going to use foam square at the back to create a little scene. Now this time, for my sentiment, I went with one that says chilling and grilling. And again, it had a weird shape and I used my scissors to cut all around it. And you can see here some close-up photos. The main reason that I love working with card kits is that you get things that they all match together. So let's move on and make a flower card. For this one, I'm working with a pattern paper that has the white lines on yellow background. I cut it to be quite small since I love the big bold border all around. And this yellow pattern paper is going to provide the ground for my elements. Now, these are the exact same patterns. If you place it like that, they seem repetitive. However, if you turn around one of them, they're going to be completely different. They don't look as identical as in the beginning. So I'm going to add a big piece of foam tape at the back, and I'm going to stick those at the bottom of my pattern paper. This leaves quite enough space at the top where you can die cut a sentiment and stick it there. You can even stamp your sentiment. I decided to go with the foam alphabet stickers. So I'm going to spell the word hello, and to spread them out evenly, I placed first the first and then last letters, then the middle one, and then placing the ones in between. So my card is finished and it has a lovely foiling on the letters. Now let's make a super cute one. For this one I decided to go with the llamas and to use that pattern paper with the watercolor effect of pinks and oranges. But I wanted to have kind of a frame all around it. That's why I'm using the other pattern paper in black and white. This is going to provide some contrasting color. So I'm going to cut it out to be super thin, like 1/8 of an inch all around. And when I place that on top of my card piece, you see the difference. It helps that pattern paper pop even more. I'm going to stick this down. And then for the top, I'm going to align those two little llamas. And I'm using foam tape at the back so that I can pop them on top of my card. This makes a great Valentine's Day card, an anniversary card, and why not for a wedding card if you want to make something crazy. And I'm going to stick the sentiment that says together time. And notice how I bring things together. They are not just stuck there. One of the llamas is standing on top of the sentiment, which is aligned with the other llama. The placement of your elements really make a difference when you are designing a card so that they don't look as if you just throw them on top of your background. You need to somehow bring your elements together. For the next card, I'm going to play with the hexagons, and I picked all the hexagons included in the kit. I'm going for a very graphic looking card, very modern design. So I'm going to play a little bit with the placement, just spreading out all the hexagons on my card. And then for sentiments, I picked three of them, which I'm going to combine. I'm sticking everything down with my Nouveau Deluxe glue, so all the hexagons are completely flat on my white panel. And then for the sentiments, I will go with foam tape at the back. And I picked one that says celebrate life, now, and party this way. You can embellish it with the sequins that are included in the kit if you want, or leave it plain as it is. I think it looks gorgeous. And I'm going to place it on a panel of this navy cardstock. This was also included in the kit. So you can make your card base out of that, and it creates a lovely background for the panel. I like to have darker borders. I think it makes it look more finished. And here are some close-up photos. Now, if you need a birthday card in no time, then this is the one for you. In less than a minute, just stick this patterned paper on top. This has gold foiling dots on top of it, and it's really stunning in real life. Then I'm going to combine two more die cuts, the one that says Best Day, which has also foiling on top, and I'm using foam squares at the back to pop it on top of my card. And finally, I'm going to finish it off with the cake and the candle on top. A more complicated card that takes lots of time to do is very special, but there are moments when we need to put together a card at the last minute, and this is a great design for that. And let's move on to the last card for today. This time I'm going to use the dies, and you can see I have cut out a bunch of different elements. I decided to go with navy blue for my flowers, just for a completely different look. I usually go with oranges, yellows, pinks, and I do love a blue flower. So I'm going to combine all those layers with gold underneath, and you can see how beautiful it looks, really elegant. And at the center, I'm going to add gold center with a foam square so that it looks dimensional. I'm going to repeat the same process for the other flower. You can see the gold through the center, but I want to have that dimensional as well. So again, I'm going to add a foam square at the center and stick a circle on top. So I'm going to repeat the same process for layering all the different pieces that I cut out for the leaves. And you can see here I have three green leaves, but for the detail, I cut them out from gold. That's how I'm going to add little details on all the elements that have gold on top. These dies are super versatile, you can use them again and again. Use them with white cardstock and color them with your alcohol markers. Use them with colored cardstock like I did here, or even use pattern paper for different designs. Now for my background, I'm going with this lovely blue cardstock, which was included in the kit. And I'm going to decide my flower composition. So I'm going to play a little bit with all the elements. And once I'm happy with the placement, I will go ahead and stick everything down. Just like always, I will stick the leaves completely flat on my card base. And for the flowers, I went with foam tip at the back. I have one of those white pre-folded cards that were in the kit, and I'm going to stick this panel on top using my Nouveau Deluxe glue. And then all that's left to do is to add a sentiment. For that, you can go ahead and stamp something, die cut a sentiment and stick it on top. I decided to go with a die cut, and I just cut out the word celebrate from gold cardstock. And this is a die that was included in a previous Spellbinders card kit. And here are some close-up photos on the last card for today. So after creating these 10 cards, I still have lots and lots of die cuts, lots of pattern paper and cardstock to create even more cards. I hope that you had fun, that you got inspired. Like always, you will find links to the kit and everything else I used down below in the description area. Don't forget to like the video and leave me a comment, it really makes a difference. Thank you all so much, and I'll see you all next time. Thank you.